mud, mud. I love your sound. I'm absolutely, positively wild about mud. I can't go around.
Awesome. Hey, what's going on, everybody? Welcome to Connecting the Dots. Another episode of Connecting the Dots. We got Philip Jisden with us as a co-host, and Martin Leakey, Flat Earth British from the UK.
Yeah, hello, everybody.
Hey, guys, what's going on?
This is just one part of a great awakening, is the mud flood. And I think it's just not mud flood alone. It's a massive subject, isn't it? There's so many fields in this.
Massive.
Before we get going, I wanted to make it abundantly clear to you guys that we'll be skipping sections of the original video. These three guys, Richard Lopez, Philip Durazini, and Flat Earth British, do a hell of a lot of rambling, talking over each other, and going off topic. I have to cut down my clips to conserve both my time and your sanity.
Martin, I'd like to show you right now. What's being directed energy being used on a population? And I don't know, maybe if my eyes are messing with me, or I'm seeing something funny. But let's have a look at this, and let's watch this together. And let me just—I just like to get your thoughts. We're talking about directed energy right here.
Well, I'm seeing flashes before it goes off, coming in from the left-hand side.
Look at that.
Jeez.
Right. Mind blown. Mind blown. Mind blown. So I wanted to show you. Let's what do you think what's going on, Martin? I mean, what do you think we're looking at right here?
Don't necessarily have to see the energy weapon hit, because it would be electromagnetic and be invisible by nature, but it would cause that.
Is this the same thing that we're seeing that in California, right? And it's mind blowing, and that we're literally at war. And with an enemy that doesn't have a face.
To someone who has 30 seconds to Google fireball on a power line, they would learn these fireballs are not caused by energy weapons, but instead are the result of a fault in the line. I do enjoy the smug-ass look on Effie British's face, however, like he has any idea what the fuck he's talking about. Energy weapons, my ass.
It's an unsettling feeling, too, while you do this research and you're coming across this new information and you're trying to get it out to people so they can digest it in a way they can, you know, where it's palatable and they can understand it. And you just, like, at the same time, you're like, what the hell is going on? You know, you kind of get that feeling that something is coming.
Earthquake in Maine this morning, 7.6. Hang on a minute, Maine is not notorious for any earthquake fault, as far as I know, on the East Coast. So what's going on there?
There was no 7.6 earthquake in Maine, you liar. These guys just make shit up so they can jerk off their smugness onto each other. It's pathetic.
Martin, did you have any evidence of such a weapon used in the medievals or something like this while searching through the pictures that you were showing the people?
Well, very, very suspect weaponry. It's not direct, is it? Because it's only in images. This is the problem.
Right. I want people to understand this too. Is that these are our hypotheses.
I don't want my lunch money going to drugs. Who's taking these drugs? What would be the point? I'm asking questions.
What are the fascists? You know, what is it?
The scepters. Hey, we don't know for sure.
We do know now with the fascists, because that it's magnets bound together to create a charge, which is exactly the magnetron that's in your microwave oven, which is also an energy weapon.
Wait. There was a medieval era unit that used a microwave as a weapon. I cannot wait to see the evidence for this.
Yeah, I think it's always been that. It's never been nukes. I don't think they've ever got the... I think it's just reversal, like anything they do, isn't it? The reverse of explosions, implosion. I don't think they ever got implosion done.
See what I mean about the rambling? The fuck are they talking about? Are nuclear weapons actually medieval microwaves?
I mean, these cities that are just seem like they've just been hit with directed, some form of directed.
Oh, yeah. I got some in India, and they look like they've been cut with a butter knife.
Oh, yes. I think a Wise Up shows a picture like that.
I've seen our artists. I don't know if you know artists, Flipper Artists on YouTube. A guy German. I got them from him. Yeah, they were awesome. Yeah.
Oh, wow. Interesting. We can say energy weapons was a thing of the past. And what they're using now. They're using it even to this day, energy weapons.
And I think a lot of the damage of the two wars also. I got evidence they were using electric fasces in the First World War. And the evidence certainly, all them holes were attributed to military shells. I think something else was going on, as I do with World War II. You know, some of these cities like Dresden and all that, I don't think it was incendiary, not that recently. Something else was going on.
I feel like I'm editing together a PSA about what conspiracy theories can do to your mind.
Any questions?
Started to code their secret language and how they talk amongst each other. You know, especially with that double-headed eagle, it makes more sense. Come to find out, it's all Tartarian.
I think it's not double-headed. It's just a slash-headed eagle. When you rip the bird apart in two sides, and you're like showing.
Oh, I'm with you. Yeah.
Like we have on the wall, like a trophy on the wall of Hunter. The bird looks like alive, but it's not really alive. It's like the symbol of conquering.
I've seen photos of with that bird, that double-headed eagle bird, with just one-headed. I mean, with the same side. Do you understand what I mean?
It's symbolism of conquering one of the races that was before. The races of ants, they had it a bird because, you know, it's a Ukrainian emblem. It's an emblem of most of the countries that were in the Union. Right. Just like Griffon was the, representation of a mix. It was like the union of Asia and Europe.
I know this is very hard to follow, but I think I get it. The double-headed eagle symbol that is prominent on lots of nations' iconography is actually a cut-in-half and flayed-out eagle. The eagle is flayed out to symbolize conquering someone. And this is important to the people in power for reasons.
Any questions?